Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. As always, we start with the SSGI graph. And if you are new to the channel, the SSGI models that we use, they are based on the properties of the electromagnetic wave. And you can find information about that on our website. We particularly look at the geometry between the planets and the moon because we know that planets transmit electromagnetic waves. It has been recorded by the Voyager spacecraft, the Cassini spacecraft. You can look up that information on the internet as well. We had a major earthquake, magnitude 7.6 on the Caribbean plate in the Cayman Islands region. Like I said, around the 8th would be more critical, and I anticipated a considerable magnitude 6 earthquake. Instead, we had magnitude 7, and this is because what I overlooked was on the 4th and 5th of February, I pointed to the planetary conjunction Mercury-Sun-Mars, but I neglected to mention the right angle with Venus. It had a long duration because Venus made a right angle with Jupiter and Saturn at the same time. And I want to emphasize this. It is always the convergence of planetary geometry that is effective for seismic activity. And we had a convergence there. It was followed by two lunar peaks, and in particular, the lunar conjunction with Jupiter on the 7th. If you count about 2 days from that lunar peak, we end up indeed later on the 8th, 9th of February. And that's where we had this magnitude 7.6. It's a large earthquake. You can find information on our website regarding these mid-7 magnitude earthquakes because we have statistics. We have a data set. You can look that up if you wish. And most of the time, about 87% of the cases with these major earthquakes, they are preceded by a convergence of conjunctions, planetary conjunctions involving Mercury and Venus. And in the remaining 13%, and this falls in that category, we had a convergence of a planetary conjunction and right angle geometry. So it's a little bit different. And I admit I neglected to mention this right angle with Venus. We also see the typical clustering of stronger earthquakes, typically the 5.5 and larger earthquakes. They don't occur so much on average. They tend to occur in temporal clusters. And that's what we see here on the SSGI graph. And that means that we have stronger earthquakes in various locations across the planet in a short time. The spatial clustering, that's what you currently see in the Aegean Sea. That is in a specific region. That's the earthquake swarm that's going on there. And I also mentioned that in the previous special update. Okay, so let's have a look at the next time frame because it's going to be pretty critical. If you look at the SGI graph up until the 21st of February, we have two times a convergence of critical planetary geometry, one possibly even more critical than the other. First on the 13th, that's tomorrow. Today we have a full moon, but tomorrow we have a convergence here of critical planetary geometry. It involves a planetary conjunction with Mercury, Venus, and Mars. It's the critical one. It converges with two semi-right angles involving also Venus and Mercury and Neptune. And it's the convergence that makes it critical. And if you look at the lunar peaks that follow on that planetary geometry, we see a lunar conjunction with Saturn and with Neptune. And if we count about 2 days from those lunar peaks, we end up around the 16th. And that could be the largest seismic response to that geometry. But we could also already see the typical clustering of stronger earthquakes, the temporal clustering, a higher 5, maybe 6 magnitude earthquakes, starting around the 14th, on the 14th and 15th. With that planetary and lunar geometry. So be on extra alert there in those days. Then, arguably even more critical, is the three planetary conjunctions that we're going to have on the 17th, on the 18th, and also on the 19th of February. The first planetary conjunction will be with Sun, Mercury, Saturn. The second with Sun, Mercury, Neptune. Both are critical if they converge, and that's the case here. And then the third, Sun, Venus, Mars. Again, look up the information on the website regarding Venus and outer planets and larger earthquakes. We have clear statistics on this. What makes this very critical is the fact that we have right angles with Venus, Mercury, and Uranus at the same time. The first is early on the 18th, Venus, Mercury, Uranus in the right angle, followed by, on the 19th, by Mercury, Venus, Uranus in the right angle. They always come in pairs, and that's because Mercury, Venus, they move rather quickly around the Sun, and then they both make the right angle with Uranus in a short time, within 2 days. And that's the case here. In the middle, we have Sun, Mercury, Neptune. So we have two planetary conjunctions involving Mercury, then we have the right angles with Mercury, Venus, and Uranus, and also a planetary conjunction Sun, Venus, Mars. That makes it really critical. Now, we're going to look at the lunar conjunctions following that planetary geometry, and then we see Moon, Earth, Uranus, that is early on the 20th, 19th, 20th, and also Moon, Earth, Jupiter on the 21st. If we count about 2 days, especially from the lunar conjunction with Jupiter, we end up around the 23rd. There could possibly be the largest seismic response. But we also have this lunar conjunction with Uranus. So I'd say from approximately the 20th to the 23rd is the time to be on extra alert for a possible large earthquake. And it's very well possible that in this time frame, we're going to have more than one larger earthquake, possibly even two magnitude 7 earthquakes. And in a worst case scenario, we could even see a magnitude 8 earthquake, because that has been 3.5 years ago since the last magnitude 8 earthquake occurred. And it's very well possible that that happens after the lunar conjunction with Jupiter around the 23rd. This is an estimate. Again, we haven't had a magnitude 7.8 earthquake in the last 2 years. The last time was in central Turkey in February 2023. Normally, they occur about 2-3 times a year. We haven't seen one in 2 years. Magnitude 8 earthquakes happen on average about 1 time a year. We haven't seen one in 3.5 years. So there are some areas on the planet that seem definitely due for such a large earthquake. Which areas exactly, we do not know, because we still cannot measure the stress levels in Earth's crust. We don't know the amount of stress and whether or not a larger fault section has reached the tipping point. And that's the uncertainty. But we do measure atmospheric anomalies, and that can give us some indication. It's in its infancy, it isn't perfect, but the last two magnitude 7 earthquakes were both preceded by atmospheric anomalies 20 days before the earthquake happened. If you look at the last atmospheric anomalies that we recorded, they seem to mark Southern California, Mexico possibly. California may be due. And also, if you look at the other side of the planet, there's the antipode, actually, and we see one in the southern Indian Ocean. And if you look up to the north over the Arabian Plate, it marks the region in around eastern Turkey, and maybe also the Carpathian Mountains in Romania. There can be larger earthquakes, magnitude 7 earthquakes. They usually occur quite deep, but that is there's definitely the potential there. These are the latest atmospheric anomalies that we recorded. We update our website frequently and also the social media, so be sure to check them out. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.